Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So after a long time I am debuting a new HyperOS 2.0 global based ROM for my Redmi Note 10 phone. So today in this video I am going to talk about this ROM feature customization, and at the last I will show you how you guys install this ROM on your phone. So let's start the video. First of all, if I go to the settings, here you can see this is the Xiaomi's brand new HyperOS 2.0 global HyperOS 2.0 settings panel, and here you can see this ROM is on top of Android 15. And when you boot up this ROM, you will get some unwanted app. Just remove this app and off the memory extension. After that, the ROM is pretty stable and you can easily use this ROM. So this ROM is very good. I will use this ROM for 20 days and I will get a good performance from this ROM. So this ROM is very good. You can see this ROM has apps opening closing animation. If you use the default themes, you will get the apps opening closing animation. And you can see this ROM has brand new HyperOS 2.0 control center, and this control center is also very cool and refined. You can see it has bouncy effect and the smoothness. You can see the transition effects, and the smoothness of this ROM is real. I do not face any kind of heating issue on this ROM. The game performance of this ROM is really good. If I go to the any game, you can see you will get the global game turbo, and this game turbo is already very good, and you will not get the voice changer option, but the game performance of this ROM is really good. I will get a good game performance from this ROM, so you can easily use this ROM. And this is a global based ROM, so you will get the Gemini option built in. I can see the Gemini option is perfectly working. I will use this Gemini and I will get a good performance, and you can easily use this Gemini. I think you guys will be satisfied with this brand new Gemini option. And in this ROM you will get a circle reset option. Just tap and hold on the gestures. I can see the circle reset option, and the circle reset option is really perfectly working on this ROM. So you can easily use the circle reset option anywhere as you want. If I go to any, if I open gallery and go here, and you can easily use the cycle reset option there. Just tap and hold the gestures, and you can easily use this cycle reset option anywhere as you want. So this is very good and cool feature. In gallery option, you will get some new HyperOS 2.0 AI functions, and the AI function, the sky, is also perfectly working. In basic, you will get some adjust option and adjust option. In adjust option, you will get some more features on there, and the create option is also perfectly working. So this is very good. And you will get the text recognize option, adjust option, and protective watermark is also there, and Google Lens is also there. And if you just tap and hold, you can easily copy the text and anything as you want. So this gallery is also perfectly working. So gallery option is perfectly working, and the camera and picture quality of this ROM is really good. You can see the camera. I think this camera quality is really pretty decent, and I will get good picture quality from this ROM. The video option is also up to 4K 30fps. You can easily use in 1080p 60fps. You will get EIS option. The video quality and picture quality is really decent. I will get a good video quality, and picture quality is also really decent on this ROM. So I think this ROM's picture quality satisfied you. And this ROM has brand new HyperOS 2.0 lock screen customization. Just tap and hold to the lock screen, click the customization, enter your password. After that, you can see this has brand new HyperOS 2.0 lock screen customization, and the lock screen customization is really perfectly working. So you can easily use the lock screen depth effect, font effect. You can change the wallpaper, font color, anything as you want, and the other things is perfectly working. So you can easily use the lock screen customization on this ROM. And this ROM has also brand new HyperOS 2.0 personalization option. If you go to the personalization, here you can see this is the brand new HyperOS 2.0 global personalization option. And this ROM has also always on display, and always on display is always, not for 10 seconds. You can easily use the always on display, and all the things is perfectly working. And this ROM has also the super power option, and super power is perfectly working, so there is no issues on there. And all the things is perfect, I think. So now I'm talking about this ROM's battery life. This ROM battery life is pretty decent. I will get a good battery life from this ROM. And most importantly, this ROM has no heating issue. When you play long time game, then you will feel some heating issue, but just normal. I will play a Free Fire or eFootball on this ROM and I will get a good performance from this ROM. And if you are a moderate level gamer or you are a hardcore gamer, then you will get a good battery life from this ROM. In daily uses, the ROM is perfect and the battery life is pretty decent. I can see I am using this ROM for a long time, but I am satisfied with the battery life, and I think the battery life is pretty good on this ROM, so you can easily use this ROM. And this ROM has some lackings. The first lacking is this ROM has no Mi Dialer and Mi Message app. This ROM has Google Dialer and Google Message app. This is you will be disappointed, but the call quality and all the things is perfectly working. The entire reception option is also perfectly working, so there is no issue on there. But this ROM has no Mi Dialer and Mi Message app, but all the things is perfectly, I can see the perfectly working. And the widgets option is also brand new, and global widgets you will get there. And settings, you can see the new layout, and some things is really decent and perfectly working. And wallpaper is also brand new, and all the apps is also perfectly working, and all the apps is HyperOS 2.0, so this is very cool and very good. And I am using this ROM for a long time, get a good performance from this ROM, and I think I will not change this ROM. I will get a good performance from this ROM, so I will use this ROM. So now I am talk about this ROM installation process. So first of all, you need to download this main ROM file. I will provide the main ROM file in my description box. After that, you need to remove all Xiaomi account and fingerprint face lock from your phone, and you need to unlock your phone bootloader mask. After that, you need to install a custom recovery on your phone. The custom recovery like Orange Fox or TWRP. After that, you will boot into the custom recovery. Then you need to click on wipe. I can see, I will show you. You click on wipe. After that, type yes. Then factory reset your phone. You will factory reset your phone. Then click on install. After that, you will click on the main ROM file. Then you will got that kind of pages. Just swipe to confirm flash, click here. After that, the installation process is also starting, and in few seconds you will get that kind of message. Just click on back. After that, just click on back. After that, you click on the reboot option, click on the reboot, then click on the system, click on system, and your phone will automatically boot into the main ROM. So you can easily use another custom recovery like OrangeFox. All the process are also pretty similar. So that's it for today. Hope you guys enjoy this video. If you guys don't understand something, message me on Telegram. I will try to help you guys. This is my Telegram channel, you can join here. And if you guys don't understand something, message me on Telegram. I will try to help you. So thanks for watching this video.